I'd like to continue this line of thinking around theodicy and even the validity of the theodicy question, and just give you kind of two little quotes and then ask you to reflect on that. One is that 2 years ago with Miroslav Volf, he at one point said, basically, atheists are closer to God than most theists because they're arguing with God constantly. I don't know that they're, but this is my question, is are they arguing with this metaphysical concept of God, or are they actually arguing with God? And why I thought of this was because somebody in this room said, it seems like Moltmann fell in love with Christ and then kind of backed into theism. Like it was Jesus first and then theism later. And I don't know if that it would accurately depict this conversion.
No. Atheism and theism are outside of the Trinity. And I believe only in the God of Christ, whom he called Abba, dear Father. So looking at Christ, I see his God. And in the community with Christ, his God becomes also my God. But theism is a general understanding of transcendence, and that there is a higher being somewhere, somehow, etc. So theism is no answer to the problem, and atheism is difficult. You see, in the 19th century, we had this type of protest atheism. The best story about it is in Dostoevsky, the brothers Karamazov. Ivan Karamazov is protesting against God because of the suffering of an innocent child. And he said, well, I have nothing against God in heaven, but that this Earth is God's kingdom. I reject this as long as there is no justice on earth. So this was a good protest atheism, and we have this type of Job protest atheism after the war in Camus and other writers, so much that the German Catholic poet Heinrich Böll once said, I don't like these atheists. They always talk about God. But there's now coming up another type of atheism, which is just banality. With Dawkins and... Well, I think Heinrich Heine said this in the 19th century already. The theodicy question is, if there is a God, why is there evil? The best answer is, there is no God. That's the best excuse for God. And then the whole question of why is there evil collapses. So only the presupposition that there is a God keeps the question of evil alive and let us hunger for righteousness on earth.
I was going to ask about that with the new atheism of Dawkins and Hitchens, etc. It seems to me, in many cases, the God that they are debunking may not necessarily be the God some of us believe in here, or the God you describe in your work. No. Can you talk a little bit about that, how the way you speak of God is different than the God that they are saying doesn't exist?
Well, they say that probably there exists no God. That is to say, they have no use for God in their life, neither negative nor positive use of God. So you can live without music, of course, but you miss a lot in your life. And so you can live without God, but you will miss a lot of the liveliness of life with this. Now, Dawkins has another world view, or Weltanschauung, as we say. For him, the genes are already egoistic, and only the stronger gene will survive. And this brought people, famous journalists in this states, David Brooks, for example, to the conviction that there is competition and the survival of the fittest already before they are human beings, already on the level of the genes. And therefore we need a strong state and a black education and all the rest conservative repression of evil, and I think this is wrong. The genes are neither egoistic nor altruistic, but there are certain pieces which switch on a gene or switch out a gene, and the genes are more socially conditioned than only biologically conditioned. So by acceptance we bring life into another person, by rejection we reduce another person, and this is beyond Darwin's understanding and Dawkins' understanding. But there are two lands or countries in Europe where atheism is widespread. This is East Germany and Czechia. And this perhaps because of a long tradition of suffering under religious persecution, etc.